Anarchism and individualism has a complicated relationship. Anarchists are often accused of being individualists in a derogatory sense by their political opponents. You know, kind of, and the political opponents will often portray anarchism or anarchists as being interested in just the individual doing as they wish, not really caring about anybody else. You know, and which is basically kind of this juvenile nihilism, if you will. And then within anarchism, you have some anarchists that will accuse other anarchists of being individualists again in a negative sense. And what they'll mean by that is that some anarchists will only be interested in kind of individual acts of rebellion or kind of experimenting with unconventional lifestyles rather than participating in and helping build social movements. So it's kind of individualism within anarchism is kind of seen as a negative sense. And then if you think kind of broadly, the popular kind of understanding of individualism has really been monopolized by this kind of neoliberal rugged individualism, if you will. It's kind of idea of the kind of like abstract individual working within the marketplace, operating within the marketplace. But individualism always meant something different to anarchists. And there's different schools of anarchist individualism. You know, you've got the American, the Italian, the French, and, you know, egoisms within that. You know, there's different ones. But what it's always meant is what we call social individualism, which is the understanding that for one to develop their individuality and realize, you know, the potential of their intellectual faculties, if you will, they have to live within a community and a society that that allows for them to have access to all the resources they need to develop that individuality. And it's within the school of socialism. So it's kind of interesting for readers today to go back and look at anarchist individualism, because what it does is it provides a new language, if you will, for anarchists and socialists to talk about socialist ideas, anarchist ideas, but through the framework of the individual, which can really help people, again, anarchists or socialists today, to talk to other people about anarchist ideas, but through a language that might be kind of more receptive to them, or a language they're more comfortable talking about, i.e. individualism rather than collectivism.